Two patients take different painkillers. One needs just a small dose to feel better, while the other needs a higher dose. But both drugs can relieve the pain completely. What's the difference? That's where potency and efficacy come in. Let's start with potency. Potency is a measure of how much of a drug is needed to produce a certain effect. Imagine drug A relieves pain completely at 5 mg, while drug B requires 20 mg to achieve the same effect. So, we say that drug A is more potent than drug B, even though both drugs can fully relieve pain. And we conclude that a more potent drug produces the same effect at a lower dose than a less potent one. Now, let's look at the dose response curve. At the very top, we see the maximum effect a drug can achieve. This is called Emax, or the maximum effect. We'll talk more about Emax later in the video when we discuss efficacy. But here's something important. If we look at the point where the response is 50% of that maximum effect and trace it down to the corresponding drug dose, that dose is called the EC₅₀. The half maximal effective concentration. So, EC₅₀ is simply the concentration of a drug needed to produce 50% of its maximum effect. And this is usually used to describe potency. The rule is, a lower EC₅₀ means the drug is more potent because it needs less drug to reach half of its maximum effect. Now, let's look at the graph. On the left side, we have drug A shown in red and drug B shown in yellow. As we can see, both drugs eventually reach the 100% effect, also known as Emax. But here's the difference. If we look at the point where the response is 50% of the maximum and trace it to the x-axis, we can determine the EC₅₀ for each drug. Drug A has a lower EC₅₀ compared to drug B. That means drug A is more potent than drug B, even though both can achieve the same maximum effect. Now, let's move to the second concept, efficacy. Efficacy is the magnitude of response a drug causes when it interacts with a receptor. In other words, it tells us how strong the effect can get. The maximal efficacy of a drug is called Emax. This is the point on the curve where the drug produces its greatest possible effect. Beyond this point, even if you keep increasing the dose, you won't see any further increase in response. Let's compare drug A and drug B. Both drugs can be used to treat pain, but notice the difference. Drug B can only reduce pain partially, while a drug A can completely eliminate it. This means that drug A has higher efficacy because it produces a stronger maximum effect. Now, let's also look at potency. To compare potency, we check the EC₅₀ of each drug, the dose that produces 50% of the maximum effect. As we can see, drug A has a lower EC₅₀ than drug B, making it more potent than drug B. Efficacy actually depends on two key factors. First, the number of drug receptor complexes formed, and second, the intrinsic activity of the drug. If you want to understand these factors in more details, don't forget to check our next video. To sum up, if we look at dose response curve, potency is shown by how far left or right the curve is. The further left, the more potent the drug. Efficacy is shown by how high the curve goes. The taller the curve, the greater the efficacy. Now that we've covered the basics of potency and efficacy, it's time for a quick quiz to test your understanding. Question number 1. Which of the following best describe potency of a drug? A, B, C, or D? Question number 2. Which statement correctly defines efficacy? A, B, C, or D? If you learned something cool today, smash that like button and hit subscribe for more bite-sized medical lessons. Drop your answers and questions in the comments. Until next time, stay curious.